Do you ever feel like you're dealing with a skin disorder that no one else has? Chances are, you're not alone. Many people suffer from common skin disorders, and it's important to be aware of what they are, how to identify them, and how to best treat them. We'll discuss 10 of the most common skin disorders, their symptoms, and ways to treat them. From eczema to psoriasis, let's take an in-depth look at how to manage these skin conditions. 1. Acne. Acne is one of the most common skin disorders and can affect people of any age. It is caused by the clogging of skin pores with dead skin cells and oil, which leads to inflammation. Common treatments for acne include over-the-counter topical creams and lotions that contain ingredients such as benzoyl peroxide or salicylic acid. These products work to reduce inflammation and kill bacteria, helping to clear up existing acne and prevent future breakouts. In addition, it's important to keep your skin clean by washing it twice a day with a mild cleanser. This helps to reduce the amount of oil and dirt that can build up in the pores. If your acne doesn't respond to over-the-counter treatments, you may want to see a dermatologist for prescription medications such as antibiotics or retinoids. 2. Atopic dermatitis. Atopic dermatitis, also known as eczema, is a chronic skin condition that can cause redness, itching, and dryness on the skin. It is often seen in children, but adults can suffer from it too. There is no cure for atopic dermatitis, but there are treatments to help manage the condition. First and foremost, it's important to understand that atopic dermatitis is not contagious. This means you can't catch it from someone else or spread it to others. When treating atopic dermatitis, the goal is to reduce symptoms and prevent flare-ups. This can be done through lifestyle changes, such as avoiding harsh soaps and detergents and wearing loose-fitting clothes. You can also try using non-irritating moisturizers and applying cool compresses. It's also important to treat any bacterial or fungal infections promptly. You may need a prescription medication such as an antibiotic or antifungal cream. Finally, there are some medications available to help control atopic dermatitis. These include corticosteroids, calcineurin inhibitors, topical immunomodulators, and systemic immunomodulators. Your doctor will help you decide which one is best for your condition. If your atopic dermatitis isn't responding to these treatments, you should speak to your doctor about further options. No matter what treatment you use for atopic dermatitis, it's important to take good care of your skin. Make sure to keep it clean and moisturized with mild products, and wear sunscreen to protect it from the sun's harmful rays. With the right care, you can reduce the symptoms of atopic dermatitis and improve your quality of life. 3. Cold sores. Cold sores, also known as fever blisters, are a common and highly contagious skin disorder. They are caused by the herpes simplex virus and usually occur on or around the lips, nose, and chin. Cold sores typically start out as red bumps and then burst and form fluid-filled blisters. The blisters can break open and leave painful ulcers that may take up to 2 weeks to heal. There is no cure for cold sores, but there are treatments that can reduce the severity and duration of an outbreak. Applying a cold compress or petroleum jelly can help reduce swelling and discomfort. Over-the-counter medications such as Abreva and Zevirax can also be used to treat cold sores. If you are experiencing severe outbreaks, your doctor may prescribe antiviral medications such as acyclovir, famciclovir, or valacyclovir to reduce the severity and duration of an outbreak. It is important to practice good hygiene to reduce the risk of spreading cold sores. Wash your hands frequently, avoid sharing utensils and towels with those who have cold sores, and abstain from kissing or engaging in other forms of physical contact until the sore has completely healed. 4. Dandruff. Dandruff is one of the most common skin disorders that people experience. It causes dryness and itchiness of the scalp, as well as white flakes that appear on the shoulders and neck. The cause of dandruff can range from skin conditions such as seborrheic dermatitis, eczema, or psoriasis to simple environmental factors such as cold weather or not shampooing frequently enough. Regardless of the cause, dandruff can be annoying and uncomfortable. Fortunately, there are several treatments available to help treat dandruff. The most common treatment is to use an anti-dandruff shampoo with ingredients such as salicylic acid or zinc pyrithione. You should also make sure to massage your scalp when you wash your hair to help stimulate the natural oils. In addition, diet can also play a role in treating dandruff. Eating foods high in healthy fats such as omega-3 fatty acids and avoiding processed foods and sugar can help reduce dandruff symptoms. Finally, if your dandruff persists despite your best efforts, it may be time to visit a doctor for a more serious treatment. A doctor may recommend a medicated shampoo, topical steroid cream, or even oral medications. 5. Hives. Hives, or urticaria, is an itchy, red rash that can affect any area of the skin. It is caused by an allergic reaction or a viral infection and can be triggered by certain foods, drugs, pollen, insect bites, and even stress. The rash usually lasts for a few hours before fading away, but some cases can last longer. The most common symptom of hives is intense itching, but they can also cause burning, stinging, and swelling. Other symptoms may include raised bumps, welts, and even blisters. Although hives typically don't pose any serious health risks, they can be very uncomfortable and should be treated promptly. If you are experiencing hives, there are several treatments you can try. Over-the-counter antihistamines such as Benadryl or Claritin can provide relief from itching and swelling. Cold compresses and oatmeal baths can also help to soothe the skin. If your hives are persistent or severe, it's important to consult a doctor for a diagnosis and proper treatment. 6. Actinic keratosis. Actinic keratosis, also known as solar keratosis, is a precancerous skin condition caused by prolonged exposure to the sun's ultraviolet rays. It is most commonly found on areas of the skin that are exposed to the sun, such as the face, ears, chest, back of the hands, and forearms. Actinic keratosis appears as rough, scaly patches on the skin that can range in color from light pink to red. The patches may be slightly raised or flat and vary in size from very small spots to larger patches. Actinic keratosis may be itchy and painful and can cause irritation if left untreated. The main risk factor for actinic keratosis is excessive sun exposure. Other risk factors include having fair skin, light eyes, and a history of sunburns. People with a weakened immune system, due to conditions like HIV, AIDS, or medications like steroids, are also at a higher risk. There are several treatments available for actinic keratosis, depending on the severity of the condition. These treatments include topical creams, cryotherapy, that is freezing with liquid nitrogen, photodynamic therapy, that is using a laser to heat and destroy abnormal cells, and surgical excision. Your doctor will help you determine which treatment is best for you. It is important to remember that actinic keratosis can turn into skin cancer if it is not treated. Therefore, it is important to talk to your doctor about any changes in your skin and follow their instructions for treatment. 7. Rosacea. Rosacea is a common skin disorder that affects millions of people around the world. This chronic inflammatory skin condition typically affects the face, though it can also appear on other areas of the body. Characterized by redness, broken blood vessels, swelling, and sometimes even pus-filled bumps, rosacea can be an embarrassing and difficult condition to live with. Fortunately, there are treatments available to help manage rosacea. Depending on your individual condition, your doctor may recommend topical medications such as antibiotics, retinoids, and anti-inflammatory creams or gels. Oral medications such as antibiotics, isotretinoin, and anti-anxiety drugs may also be prescribed. Laser treatments and photodynamic therapy may also be used to reduce inflammation and reduce the appearance of any visible redness or broken capillaries. With proper care, you can manage your rosacea and improve the appearance of your skin. 8. Psoriasis. Psoriasis is a common skin disorder that affects over 8 million people in the United States. It is an autoimmune condition that causes red, scaly patches of skin to form on various parts of the body. In some cases, these patches can be itchy and painful. The exact cause of psoriasis is unknown, but there are several factors that may contribute to it. These include genetics, environmental factors, and certain medications. Stress can also be a trigger for psoriasis flare-ups. The good news is that psoriasis is treatable. Treatment plans may include topical creams, oral medications, phototherapy, or a combination of treatments. Your doctor will work with you to develop a plan that is tailored to your individual needs and lifestyle. It's important to remember that psoriasis is a chronic condition and there is no cure. However, the right treatment can help control symptoms and keep your skin healthy. 9. Carbuncle. A carbuncle is an infection that forms when several hair follicles become inflamed and infected at the same time. It usually occurs in areas of the body with a lot of hair, such as the scalp, back, neck, or shoulders. It can be painful and cause a fever. Carbuncles are caused by the same bacteria that cause other skin infections, such as boils, impetigo, and cellulitis. The bacteria enter the skin through a cut or scrape, often from shaving or wearing tight clothing. Once inside the skin, the bacteria can multiply and form an abscess or pocket of pus. The pocket of pus is known as a carbuncle. If you suspect you have a carbuncle, it's important to see your doctor right away. Carbuncles are contagious and can spread to other parts of your body if not treated properly. Treatment typically involves antibiotics, draining the pocket of pus, and covering the area with a clean bandage. If you have a carbuncle, it's important to keep the area clean and dry, avoid scratching or picking at it, and wear loose-fitting clothing to prevent further irritation. Make sure to follow your doctor's instructions for taking antibiotics and caring for the infected area. With proper care, most carbuncles can be treated successfully. 10. Shingles. Shingles is a painful, blistering skin rash caused by the varicella zoster virus, which is the same virus that causes chickenpox. After someone recovers from chickenpox, the virus can stay in the body in a dormant or inactive state. Years later, it can reactivate and cause shingles. The early signs and symptoms of shingles include pain, itching, or tingling in a specific area of the body, usually on one side. After several days, the rash will develop into fluid-filled blisters that may ooze and form a crust before healing. Treatment for shingles includes antiviral drugs, over-the-counter pain medications, anti-inflammatory medications, cool compresses, wet wraps, and topical creams to help soothe the area. For severe cases of shingles, oral steroids or other immunosuppressants may be prescribed. In some cases, surgery may be necessary to remove affected skin and scar tissue. It is important to seek treatment for shingles as soon as possible to reduce the risk of long-term complications such as postherpetic neuralgia, which is a condition characterized by persistent pain in the area where the shingles rash occurred. Additionally, if you have had shingles, getting vaccinated against the virus to prevent future outbreaks is an option. For more health videos, subscribe to Healthy Lifestyle Tips.